What's up, guys? It's Brandon from Adventuring Minimals. Want to give you a little tour of our new home on wheels. So we've been planning on doing RV life for quite a while now, and we had looked at tons of RVs in Vegas where we were living at the time, and we just didn't fall in love with any of them. Like, we liked them, but we didn't love them, and we felt like if we were going to be living in something, we had to be in love with it. So we were actually in Oregon visiting some friends, and we decided to go look at some RVs while we were up there, and we came across this one they had just gotten in. It's a used one, it's 2015, but it was in great condition, low mileage, and we fell in love with it. Like, right when we walked in, it felt like home. It had everything we wanted in it, so we decided to go ahead and pick it up and cancel our flights home and drove it back to Vegas and started our journey there. So this is our 2015 Coachman Prism. It is on the Mercedes-Benz Sprinter 3500 chassis. We went with this chassis because it has the 3-liter V6 diesel engine in it, which is great, reliable, and way better on gas than a gas engine. So when we bought it, it had 29,000 miles on it, which is really low for a diesel engine, and we're really pleased with it. And then the sleeping area is a Coachman Prism 21-foot sleeping area, so from front bumper to back bumper is 25 feet long. So that's the outside of the RV. Let's go ahead and hop inside and check out the inside.
So this is our kitchen. Basically, it's small, but we actually really like it. It's kind of fun being all crowded next to each other trying to cook our meals. But we do have this cool little pop-up that I would say gets so, or becomes so convenient. We set everything on it, and then we do have our sink here, which fills up with dishes, and it's very nice to be able to actually have somewhere to dry them off, not have it all cluttered over here. What is this? It's a 3-burner propane stove. I'm good. we use it quite often, to be honest. I wasn't sure that we were actually going to use a stove at all. I figured we'd probably use the convectional microwave and then microwave itself, but we actually use the stove a lot. We do have an oven, which is really nice. Thinking about it, we might be on the road for holidays, so we won't fit a turkey in here by no means, but I could fit some stuffing or something. This is our water machine. Everyone that comes in here or whoever came to our house before was always like, what is that? And it basically filters your water. So Brandon and I are both Enagic distributors, which is the company that creates these machines and has machines for your showers and so on. It's incredible because you really don't notice or realize that there is a difference between water and good water, right? There's a difference between organic and not, GMO and not, and having gluten or all of these things in your food. Why shouldn't it be the same with your water? Well, it is, and so this machine goes everywhere with us. To be honest, it saves us a lot of money in the long run from having to buy bottled water all the time, plus all the plastic. Don't want that for the environment, right? So yeah, this is kind of our kitchen area. This backing, I hope you like it. I love it, but it took me forever to do. I ripped it off 6 times at least 6 times that I can remember. If you aren't familiar with this, it's basically like a peel and stick. So it's really easy once you kind of line it all up and you can get it down. The corners around these edges were pretty complicated, but you can do it. Make sure that you do line it up where your laps, like your overlap, meets nicely. That was really hard on the ends because I wanted to make sure that it was a clean line. So if you do this, kind of beware of that beforehand. Learn from my 6 times ahead of time, but I think it looks pretty good now. Brandon and I made these curtain or like panel coverings. They used to be like a really old brownish black pattern, you know, typical RVs furniture, and we took them off and replaced them with some blue, so that way it brought in our dinette and all of our other blue that we wanted to kind of bring into the kitchen and to the RV itself. So yeah, this is our kitchen area. This is where all the yummy, tasty food happens, and surprisingly, we actually do cook in here for almost every meal. People have asked us, like, you guys eat out a lot, and we do love eating out, so if we are somewhere really cool, don't get us wrong, we're not gonna not go escape and take an Uber or ride our bikes, but majority of the time we do like to cook in here, and it's fun to get to do it together and be so close because you really don't have any space apart. Over here now, our dinette, I guess you'd call this a dining area, living area, kind of all of the above, but we do have our cat hammock, which I would say is the most important part of this entire area, because our cats love this hammock. They take naps in here, they play around in here, they stare out at the birds in here, they love this thing. So if you are somebody who has cats, look it up on Amazon, and maybe we'll put it somewhere in the video, but these are awesome. They're cheap, they're really easy to take on and off, and yeah, your cats will love them. But this table is a really cool table. Our friends Sarah and Alex told us about it. They live in a van and kind of redid and built all of their stuff, and this table was something that they had and we really liked it. So it basically allows you to move your tabletop anywhere around, and you basically can like stretch it out over there. You can put it out all the way flat. You can even like line it up completely vertical this way. So it's a really cool, neat table. We have it put together with the dinette that my dad and Brandon built out. So this that I'm sitting on wasn't actually in here when we bought this RV. We had two huge recliners and it actually made this area feel really, really tight and small. And it's really not. It's a pretty wide area, especially with the slide out. And so we didn't want to keep those in there. Plus, we work on computers. It's a lot easier to be able to have something on a table and have proper, you know, posture, which we don't have either. We're working on it. So we got rid of the recliners, and my dad and Brandon spent a weekend building this dinette and the backings and basically this awesome cat litter box that does have a airtight suction sealed little vent and door. And it basically just works perfectly for the two of us. I did create these cushions and these pillows myself. Basically, I super glued some Velcro pieces to the backs of these with some wood panels, and then also then Velcroed it to the back so that way they stay in. But I can still take it off and wash the cloth if I need to, because obviously cats have hair. And the bottom of these I also made too, and we have wood on the bottom. That way it can basically be taken off, washed, replaced if we choose to do a different color maybe sometime. But yeah, the cats love this area, hence little Stoney girl taking a nap and enjoying her time. But yeah, we do spend a lot of our time in here too, but we also lay in bed. I mean, who doesn't like bed?
So before we leave the kitchen area, we do have a fridge and freezer from Dometic. You guys are probably thinking, where's your fridge and freezer? We do have one, nice and full. Just went grocery shopping. Got some pizzas and stuff in there that we do actually cook in the convectional microwave. We haven't even used the oven yet, so.
And they've been tasty.
Yeah, they were really good. And then not too far from that area is our bedroom. So we have a full-size bed, between a twin and a full. But it's just a regular RV mattress, and we have a memory foam topper on it, which makes it nice and comfy, right?
Any person who sits on our bed is always like, oh wow, this is a really nice bed.
Yeah, they're usually thinking it's going to be a very stiff, hard bed, which mostly come in RVs. But yeah, we got lucky in the when we bought this thing, there was already a mattress topper on it, so we lucked out on that. But up here we have storage. Also, these three are for Kayla, and then those two are for me, but that's actually three as well because it goes back in that way, so we have the same amount of space. But I keep most of my clothes in there, and Kayla keeps like her underwear and socks and bathing suits in this, and then she gets most of the closet. So here's our closet, Kayla's shirts and then jackets, and we actually have our dirty clothes hamper hung up in here.
And some cat food.
And some cat food. Yeah, this is our closet. That's all we have.
That's all the clothes. It was actually, I'm going to be real, the hardest part for me. Because I was getting rid of clothes I didn't really want to get rid of.
Yeah, so I actually posted a post on Instagram today and asked people what their hardest thing was for transitioning to full-time RV. And somebody commented on there and said downsizing. So getting, what do you get rid of? You've had stuff for years and years and you don't want to get rid of it. And all these clothes we have, like, I have a bunch of clothes. Kayla had a bunch of clothes that we never wore. We wore the same thing every week, pretty much. So it wasn't too bad. But, yeah, we did have to get rid of a lot of stuff. But it's not too bad. And then in this one, we have a little pantry area. Just got random stuff. Breads and cans and cups back there. But, yeah, that's our pantry area. And then down here, we just have drawers for silverware, tin foil, plastic baggies,
all the necessities,
napkins, yeah, just stuff like that. In here we have a toaster, a little I don't know what that's called.
Strainer.
I know a strainer, but what's this thing? A blender?
Oh.
A baking whisk?
Yeah. Yeah. It's like a little KitchenAid.
Yeah.
Whisk.
Yeah, we just got stuff in there. And then you're in the bathroom area. That far. So right here we have a medicine cabinet, all our stuff, pretty good sized medicine cabinet, we got quite a bit of stuff in there.
Gotta keep us clean, you know, we don't shower every day.
Yeah. We got a sink here, which is one of the main reasons Kayla wanted this RV, is because the sink was outside of the bathroom. A lot of RVs you see, the sink's inside the bathroom and gets a little crammed in there, or if you, somebody's in there showering, you don't want to go in there and bother him or whatever, but
it just gets nice and humid when you're trying to get ready.
So, and if you have guests over, they don't have to go into the bathroom to do anything if somebody's in the bathroom. So, yeah, it's nice to have this out here. Tons of storage over here. There's cubbies over here. Keep our toothbrushes. Storage under there. Drawer right here. For how small this thing is, only being a 21-foot living area, it's actually got a ton of storage, which is another reason we liked it and got it. And then into here, we got the bathroom. So your normal bathroom, just a shower, toilet, and a cabinet up there where we keep our towels and stuff. But yeah, pretty simple. But yeah, that's our home. We've been on the road for a month now. We've started in Las Vegas, and now we are here in Maine. And then we're going to be heading up into Canada after here in a few days. But, yeah, we love it so far. It's been a really good change of pace. Not just sitting at home all day, every day. Now we actually get out and see the world and adventure. And we love to travel. So what better way than to live in an RV and travel full time? So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed our tour of our RV. If you're new here, please consider subscribing. Give this video a thumbs up. If you have any questions for us, drop a comment below and we'll get back to you. We're gonna be putting out new videos every week about RV life, so be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you guys on another one.